Thank you. treasure and profound pride for me to be at this red laying ceremony honoring Cuban fallen soldiers in Africa, to remember the courage and determination of heroes and heroines of Cuba who gave their precious life to uphold the great banner of freedom of our people and the sovereignty and territorial integrity of my country, Ethiopia in particular. This spirit of internationalism and genuine friendship was demonstrated by Cubans, was to make our world a best place where freedom and justice prevail, and of course, to inherit as a world system that highly values peace and order. Those sons and daughters of Cuba deserve eternal recognition as they gallantly battled the injustice emanating from colonialism and apartheid and showed that the pursuit of humanity and sacrifice for the good of Africans in a world of geopolitical cynicism. Excellency Minister, Madam Deputy President of the Association, distinguished ambassadors, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. In the late 1970s, when Siad Barre of Somalia violated the territorial integrity of Ethiopia, no one would be cited as a witness of the historic event other than the late leader of Cuba, Brother Fidel Castro. With a sense of curiosity and brotherhood, Fidel was pioneer to wrap the cloud of war hanging on the skies of Ethiopia and Somalia. The last leg of his initiative was the city of Aden, then the capital city of South Yemen. And unfortunately, Siad Barre put all the efforts of Fidel Castro in vain. This was how Fidel recalled the lengthy negotiation in the event. I quote, "We called a meeting in Aden, South Yemen, with the leaders of Ethiopia, Yemen, and Somalia to prevent the hanging war. It could not be prevented. I've made up my mind about Siad Barre. He's above all a chauvinist. Chauvinism is the most important factor in him." End of quotation. It was at this juncture Fidel had decided to back Ethiopia to defend its territorial integrity and sovereignty. At a time when others switched sides and we were alone, Ethiopia is alone at the time, more than 17,000 Cuban troops and advisors heralded their arrival to face our common enemy. Those Cuban heroes and heroines, alongside Ethiopian defense forces, bravely defended our country by paying the ultimate sacrifice. The war between Ethiopia and Somalia caused much casualty and took the lives of 163 Cuban soldiers and many more from Ethiopia. As the result of the ambition of Siad Barre to create greater Somalia by downsizing Somalia's neighbors, that dream had gone forever. Now the situation at the Horn of Africa have changed to the good of the peace and security of our region, the Horn of Africa, and of that of the border at large. Ministers, Deputy President of the Association, ambassadors, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. The people of Ethiopia never forget the great contribution of the government and people of Cuba. I therefore save this opportunity to express my deep gratitude and sincere appreciation to Fidel and those Cuban gallant fighters as well as all Cubans. I want to say thank you to the distinguished Cuban internationalist combatants who have been with us shoulder to shoulder in Ethiopia in those very bad days of Ethiopia. And I also want to say thank you to all Cubans. The government of Cuba was led by the late Comrade Fidel Castro on behalf of the people and government of Ethiopia and that of my own, and would like to reassure you our determination to continue to honor the fallen Cuban soldiers by working diligently together for the realization of a better world where every mankind is granted with peace, equality, freedom, and happiness. It is therefore our responsibility to uphold the legacy of brotherhood and collaboration left by those eminent bridges of friendship, and we therefore need to move forward in solidifying our collaboration. It is the right time to renew our joint efforts to create a better future for our two peoples. Bilaterally, our two countries are enjoying an excellent relationship based on trust and mutual interest. We are working together on various development priorities, among which education, health, science and technology are the sectors where our cooperation is well positioned. We need to work on to further strengthen and replicate on investment and in trade to respond to the needs of the day of the world that we are living today. The emerging Ethiopian economy makes this aspiration feasible and presents immense opportunities for our two countries and to our two peoples to jointly work for our common benefit. Excellencies, ministers, Excellency ambassadors, ladies and gentlemen, on November 25th, 2017, there was a photo exhibition in Addis Ababa to commemorate the first year of the passing away of Fidel Castro. The title was Fidel and Ethiopia, the ties sealed with blood. The main message delivered through this motto elucidates that Ethiopia and Cuba have bilateral relations furnished by people-to-people ties and a foundation cemented and sealed with blood. We have to put this reality at the center of principle of our relation and work hard for our common destiny. I would like to conclude my speech by expressing my deep gratitude to the government and people of Cuba who have contributed so hard to enhance the friendship and cooperation between our two countries. Eternal glory to the heroes and heroines who fell in the battle against the enemy and gave their lives for the freedom and happiness of the people of Ethiopia. I thank you. Muchas gracias. Thank you.
ውጤታማ ያለው ቀጣይነት ያለው የማያቋርጥ ትብብር ለሁለቱም ሀገሮች ጥቅም ሊሰጥ የሚችል መስክም ለይተናል። ይህ ምንድን ነው? በክትባት ማምረትን በተመለከተ ኪዩባ በዓለም የታወቀች እና በምርምርም መጥቃ የሄደችበት ሁኔታ ነው ያለው። ስለዚህ በክትባት መድኃኒቶችም ሆነ በፈዋሽ መድኃኒቶች ዙሪያ ከኪዩባ ጋር መስራት ይቻላል የሚለውን ለይተናል። ሁለተኛው በሳይንስና ቴክኖሎጂ እንስሳት ልማት፣ በእንስሳት የጤና አጠባበቅ፣ ባዮቴክኖሎጂ በተለይ ቲሹ ካልቸር የሚሉት ምክንያቱም ስኳር ኢንዱስትሪ በኪዩባ በጣም ትልቅ ኢንዱስትሪ ነው። እኛ ደግሞ ወደዛ እያተወከሉ ሁል ጊዜ ምርታማነቱን ለመጨመር ምርምሮች ይካሄዳሉ። በዚህ ኪዩባ አሁንም በዓለም የተሻለ የምርምር ውጤት የታየበት ሀገር ነው። ቲሹ ካልቸር የሚባል የተሻለ ሸንኮራ አገዳ ጥሩ ውጤት መስጠት የሚችል ጥሩ ብዙ ስኳር መስጠት የሚችል ሸንኮራ አገዳ በማምረት በዚህ ይገባሉ ነው። ስለዚህ ጉብኝቱ በጣም ሁላችንም ብቻ ሳይሆን መላው የልዑካን ቡድኑ አባላት ከኪዩባ ብዙ መጠቀም እንደምንችል የተገነዘበ